بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد. الحمد لله إخوان, after our break in the سلسلة and in the series The Doubts Around the دعوة السلفية المباركة in the West, we return back to our discussion of a new set of doubts, which in actuality are not new. They are nothing but regurgitated, revived doubts that have been brought back by an individual known as Muhammad Hijab. Muhammad Nabil Hijab al-Masri, an individual who has crept into the Dawah arena in the last few years, a young enthusiastic YouTuber who now begins to have some following on the various social media platforms. This individual who, without doubt, is a pauper in relation to knowledge, and in relation to true ilm, in relation to the methodology of Salafi and the manhaj of Salaf, in relation to the methodology, in fact, of the prophets and the messengers in calling to Allah Azza wa Jal, which is sad since he has established himself and erected himself as one that claims to be a caller to Allah Azza wa Jal. If that is the case, then it is imperative that you're acquainted with the methodology of the prophets and the messengers in giving da'wah. And with what has become manifestly clear is that he is not acquainted with the methodology of the prophets and the messengers in giving da'wah, and thus he entered into takhabbut and confusion in his call. And from the most dangerous forms of confusion that he has manifested in his da'wah is the utilization of the method of the falasifa, the method of the philosophers in calling to Allah Azza wa Jal, a dangerous method, which though many of his followers cannot see and cannot understand the dangers that are present within using that philosophy and in employing the usage of philosophical rhetoric in the da'wah and what it leads to and what it can lead to and what it has led to in the past, and the development of the various groups of bid'ah and innovation that have stemmed from the utilization of this rhetorical, philosophical da'wah, the dangers that are present within this da'wah is something, Ikhwan, that has to be highlighted. And when we have an individual that now begins to gain popularity, and we have innocent, unsuspecting Muslims who fall into listening and following and inclining towards this da'wah, and the da'wah is not based in the da'wah of the prophets and the messengers and in the da'wah of the Salaf al-Salihun, when that is the case, it is imperative that these affairs must be highlighted. And that is what some of our brothers embarked upon doing. That they approached Muhammad Hijab, approached him in order to advise him that your da'wah, it lacks certain affairs and you have fallen into great error, grave error in other areas. That you have fallen into using the kalam of the falasifa, the philosophers, and that you rely greatly upon the affair of opinion. That is something that the Salaf of this Ummah would warn against. Umar radiallahu anhu, he mentioned, Iyakum wa ahli al-ra'i. Iyakum wa ahli al-ra'i. أعيتهم الأحاديث أن يحفظوها فقالوا بالرأي فضلوا وأضلوا. He said, be aware of the people of opinion. They became fatigued with memorizing hadith, and so they spoke with opinion, they went astray and they led others astray. And so that was what was observed from the da'wah of Muhammad Hijab, him using opinion, and everything is based upon his opinion and the way I see it, and in my opinion and my view. And this is not the opinion of one that has studied the deen formally with any of the people of knowledge. Not the opinion of a person who is grounded in the fundamentals of the religion, those fundamentals that were left for us by the Salaf of this Ummah, the Sahaba, their students, the Tabi'een, and the Atba' al-Tabi'un, their students. Not grounded in any of that. In fact, grounded in philosophical rhetoric and grounded in the speech of the people of innovation of the past. And so when we see this and when we observe this, it is a must that advice is given. And so he has been advised by a number of our brothers on more than one occasion. And of course, Ikhwan, it is that advice that has started this problem. Because when he was advised, rather than accepting the advice and at least looking into the affair, this brother embarked upon a smear campaign to blemish the character, or to attempt, rather, to blemish the character of those who have advised him. And that is, of course, the way the people of innovation of the past, the the way of the people of Hawa of the past. That is always their way. That rather than accept the advice and look at the affair from a knowledge standpoint, let us just go on a smear campaign against those who have advised us. These individuals intend good for you, and you do nothing but harm and attempt to harm them. But alhamdulillah, the Prophet ﷺ has informed us, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق لا يضرهم من خذلهم ولا من خالفهم حتى يأتي أمر الله وهم على ذلك. That there will never cease to be a group from among my ummah manifest upon the truth, not being harmed by those who oppose them or those who forsake them, until the affair of Allah comes and they remain upon that. And so this smear campaign, ikhwan, it only harms Muhammad Hijab. It doesn't harm the proponents and the defenders of the Manhaj al-Salafi at all. But what it has likewise done, it has brought many of the affairs of Muhammad Hijab to the forefront. And we have seen a different side to Muhammad Hijab throughout this affair. We have previously seen the various sides of Muhammad Hijab. Muhammad Hijab the philosopher, Muhammad Hijab with his friends, Muhammad Hijab in the park, Muhammad Hijab in the gym. We have seen all of these various sides. Muhammad Hijab the court jester. We've seen all of these sides of Muhammad Hijab, but now we have seen the side of Muhammad Hijab that he has previously kept obscure. And that is this venomous, malicious Muhammad Hijab. A malicious campaign that is embarked upon only with the intent of maligning those who have advised him. But we know that this campaign was a strategic campaign. It was planned. Yani, this smear campaign, it was planned in order to turn the people away from the advice that has been given to him. And number two, to malign and to attempt to harm and erect a smoke screen in front of those who have advised Muhammad Hijab. Harm them and to erect a smoke screen between the people and their dawah. And the proof that it is a strategic campaign and it was not based upon sincerity is the statement of Muhammad Hijab himself.
And the last couple of weeks has been a campaign that we have strategically decided to do because of what we believe is a perceived threat to the entire dawah, which is the Tabdi'i project of the S-Pubs.
Now, a strategic campaign that was based upon what we perceive. Who is we? Yeah, any alim, any talib ilm even, we perceive to be a threat, yani, to Islam and a threat to the dawah, and that is the Tabdi'i campaign, mashallah. The Tabdi'i campaign. What is it? What is this Tabdi'i campaign? Ya Muhammad, yani, is it the fact that from among the proponents of the da'wah salafiyya are those who dislike bid'ah and hate that anyone should add to the religion of Allah Azza wa Jal? Is it because of the fact that the Salaf of this Ummah, min qadim al-zaman, as Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullahu ta'ala has mentioned, that they established, in, as he mentions in Madarij al-Salikin, ashaddu al-nakir, that their warning against bid'ah and them shouting from the various lands against the people of innovation was stronger and more staunch than them warning against fawahish, and then warning against dhulm, and then warning against udwan, warning against lewdness and oppression and transgression. Worse and stronger than that. And so is the problem of this Tabdi'i campaign, is it that we have individuals that have established what the Salaf of this Ummah were upon in this time? Or would you much prefer that we leave alone dealing with and tackling innovation, and that we allow the religion to be defiled by anyone who wishes to speak about it? And this is his opinion. Again, what we saw. And we have from his various recordings that which proves that his intent is that the people take and benefit from the diversity that is present within the Ummah. That is because Muhammad Hijab is what the Salaf of this Ummah would refer to as Hatib Lail. The scholars of hadith, they would have a title for individuals that was not a praiseworthy title for certain individuals. And that is that they would refer to them as Hatibul Layl. The Hatibul Layl is the individual that gathers firewood by night. The one that gathers from here, gathers from there, gathers firewood by night. And the problem with gathering firewood by night is that among that firewood, among what you've gathered, there's going to be rubbish. A piece of concrete that can't burn. Twigs, wrappers that are not burnable. Yani, debris. That is just a pure waste of time. And so the Hatib Layl was dispraised because of him taking from various sources. And this is something that we see Muhammad Hijab being upon in his da'wah. That he takes from various sources. Doesn't matter. Sunnah, bid'ah, doesn't matter. Takes from various sources because he is from the gatherers of firewood by night. And that is something that he mentions with his own admission. That he tries to keep his da'wah neutral. And that he'll take not only from Salafi sources, but he'll take from the Asha'ira. He'll take them from the people of Ta'wil and negation of Sifat and other than that, because he tries to keep his da'wah neutral, he claims.
Consult with the works of Ibn Taymiyyah, consult with the works of Al-Ghazali, consult with the works of Al-Ghazali, Juwayni, and so on and so forth, Baqillani, because I need to make sure that, okay, this I can use this argument. So the arguments we put forward, and this is our strategic focus, to be completely honest, yeah, my area of research is this, the philosophy of religion,
and so we'll take from Sheikh al-Islam, and we take from Baqilani and Juwayni and all of these other individuals who fell into error in Aqidah, because we want to keep our da'wah yani neutral and make sure that we're taking from various sources. And this call to Allah Azza wa Jal, we attempt and we wish to keep it neutral so everyone can take it. And anyone who is familiar with the methodology and the manhaj al-Salafi and with the statements of the people of knowledge, they will know that this is what is referred to as the manhaj al-Tajmi'i. The manhaj al-Tajmi'i is an Ikhwani methodology. And that is, it only seeks to gather. And it doesn't seek to purify. It doesn't seek to keep the people upon what is correct and to safeguard them from what is false. No, it only seeks to gather. And of course, when our only platform is social media, when our only platform are the various social media platforms, then it all revolves around following. And since our da'wah revolves around just following and numbers and following and numbers, then we have to be tajmi'i in our approach, which is ikhwani. That is, we're going to gather whomsoever is able to gather with us, working with the principle that ta'awun فيما اتفقنا عليه ويأذر بعضنا بعضا فيما اختلفنا فيه. That we cooperate upon, we agree upon, and that we excuse each other upon what we disagree upon. And so, the Tajmi'i methodology, which is a methodology that just gathers numbers, that is all that is important, the Tajmi'i methodology does not look to purify, rather it only looks to gather. And thus, we see this present within the da'wah. So they avoid, or in the da'wah of Muhammad Hijab, they'll avoid topics that are sensitive and that some people may not like that you discuss. And so if you look, for example, at his da'wah, you'll see he only debates in relation to those who he confronts. He only debates atheists, non-Muslims, Christians. And among the ummah, or those who at least attribute themselves to Islam, he debates the Shia and he debates the Ahmadiyya. Wabas. He debates the Shia and he debates the Ahmadiyya. And you'll rarely find him debating anyone else, because his methodology and his approach is one that is tajmi'i. It only seeks to gather. And so he embarked then upon this campaign, smear campaign, against the brothers at Salafi Publications. And he did so in order to make the brothers look bad, intentionally. And this is, again, something that he makes admission to with his own statement.
That we can do the same kind of thing. We won't lie about you. We will hyperbolize what you do, emphasize your mistakes, and make you look very bad.
So we won't lie about you, but we will hyperbolize your mistakes and we will exaggerate them. And will make you look very bad. That is with his own admission. And so this campaign then, and everything that is connected to it, and all of the rubbish that has been spread, and the lies, and the fabrications, and the deceit, is purely to make you look bad. Because it was as though this is a game to Muhammad Hijab that he believes that he has won. I've gained followers, people have listened, and now I've won and you have lost. A game. Listen to his statement.
Finally, the job has been done. I can confirm that after more than 500,000 views on YouTube, if you put all the videos together that relate to this, probably about 300,000 to 500,000 views on just YouTube, and then on Instagram and Twitter, all the things there, add it all up, maybe even 600,000 to 700,000 people it got to. And a lot of it was targeted views. Got to the people in the cult. We got the people at the cult. You don't know how many people came out of this cult, by the way, messaging us and telling us, you know what, we used to listen to these people and now we don't listen to them anymore. Those who were sympathizers to the cult, who could have potentially joined the cult, now we're getting reports, like a plethora of reports telling us we're no longer in the cult. We had nothing to lose and you had everything to lose and you lost. Financially, everywhere you lost.
And so, we clearly hear that this was a targeted campaign in order to turn the people away from Salafi publications. It wasn't one that had any sincere intent of advice, for example, or something that you see or you believe to be a mukhalafa ilmiya, no. Some opposition to true and correct knowledge, no. Purely smear campaign, which was intended to make you look bad, intended to make you lose followers, intended to turn people away from you. That is what we hear from Muhammad Hijab. And so you'll find and you'll see that in and throughout this campaign he's been hugely disrespectful. As a young man, a young boy, as he likes to refer to his opponents. Because in actuality, the disrespect that he has shown, for example, to Dr. Amjad Rafiq, Abu Iyad, the disrespect that he has shown to Amjad Rafiq, who could be his father, is old enough to be his father. And the proof of that, I am slightly younger than Amjad, than Abu Iyad. He's slightly older than me. My son Hakim, when Muhammad Hijab was born, Hakim was 7 months old. And our brother Abu Iyad, Hafidhullah, is slightly older than me. And so, a man that is old enough to be his father, we find him being hugely disrespectful. Milkshake and calcium kid and other than that. And then the of course, unsuspected follower, he believes that this is correct and this is right. And of course, we've followed Muhammad Hijab and this is a sincere brother. And so he wouldn't do this unless he knew that this was something that should be done and that they deserved it. And so what we want to do then, in the course of the next few parts, we want to look at some of the statements of Muhammad Hijab. We want to look at his da'wah, analyze his da'wah. And see what exactly is the issue with Muhammad Hijab. What is the problem? And we want to look and see whether or not our statements against him, that many of the people, incidentally, do not even understand, have not yet grasped. Many people don't actually know what the issue is. And so we're going to look in the parts that are to come, bi'idhnillah, concerning the statements, what they are exactly, and how we understand them. And where in the scheme of things, whether Muhammad Hijab was correct in what he's embarked upon or whether he's incorrect. And you will see, without a shadow of a doubt, that Muhammad Hijab is mulabbis, he's deceitful, he's treacherous, he's a liar, and that his da'wah is not the da'wah of the prophets and the messengers and the salaf of this ummah. And thus we have referred to this part of doubts around the da'wah as Kashf al-Niqab and Muhammad al-Hijab al-Mulabbis al-Muftari al-Kadhab. Removing the veil from Muhammad Hijab, the deceitful, fraudulent liar. And we'll look, inshallah, in each of these parts at that which is related to the case of Muhammad Hijab. والله تعالى أعلم وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله.